Good morning, dear student. Yesterday we have completed laboratory pathological laboratory test CBC, that is complete blood count, bleeding time, clotting time, and other profiles. Now today we are going to study heart function test. It is another test which is going to applied on heart patient or patient who is suffering from the cardiac disease. Number one is electrocardiogram, and ECG is a cardiac screening test that should be done on the everyone of their first visit to the cardiologist. If you are going to cardiologist, then he will ask ECG. After the ECG, only he will see or find out the condition of patient. ECG stabilizes the baseline information about the structure of heart, its electric conduction pattern, and possible arrhythmias. Echocardiogram, another test. A echocardiogram is a non-invasive ultrasound cardiac screening test that records specific geographical areas of beating heart, which reveals blood flow pattern and allows to measure the size and wall thickness of the heart chamber. So this is another test of cardiac patient, echocardiogram. Now, exercise nuclear stress test. An exercise stress heart test is ordered to assess how heart is functioning when heart rate and blood pressures are increased during the physical exertion. So at the time of physical activity, excessive physical activity, or in the exercise condition, at that time the working of heart, functioning of heart, we can monitor by this test. Now next is Holter monitoring test. A Holter monitoring test is usually worn 24 hours and records every heartbeat for the time period. The electrodes are placed on the chest and record is worn on a shoulder strap. It is ordered to identify cardiac arrhythmia to monitor how well medication is working to minimize them. So basically this test is applied for the study of patterns of rhythm or pattern of rhythmicity of heart. So and also monitor the effect of drug on a heart, how drug is working on a heart to maintain the rhythmicity. Now next is laboratory test for liver. This is a liver, this also we can say liver function test. This group of test indirectly assess the health of liver cells by measuring the enzyme arising from the cells, also assess substance produced by the liver and used elsewhere in the body. If the liver enzymes are rise, it can suggest the damage to liver cells, such as occur in chronic alcoholism or with the certain viral infection, such as viral hepatitis, will affect the liver function. Some common liver function test includes alanine transaminase test, ALT. Alanine transaminase test is used by our body to metabolize protein. If the liver is damaged or not functioning properly, alanine transaminase is released into a blood. This is causes ALT levels to increase. A high result on this test can be a sign of liver damage. Second is aspartate transaminase test. Aspartate transaminostase is an enzyme found in a several part of body since AST levels are not specific for liver damage. It is usually measured together with ALT, alanine transaminostase, to check the liver problem. When liver is damaged, AST is released into a bloodstream. So for this test, you are not going to take another sample or sample from some other place. That is not required. Only through the blood, you can go for the test of all liver function test. A high result on an AST test, the liver is damaged. AST test might indicate a problem with the liver and its muscles. So these both tests are related with the concentration of enzyme which is required or which is present in a bloodstream. We can find out the functioning of liver by the enzyme level in a blood. We can see. Now, next is alkaline phosphate test. An alkaline test is typically ordered in the combination with several other tests. High levels of ALP may indicate liver damage, blockage of the bile duct, or bone disease. This limit of alkaline phosphate up to the age of 14 or 15 year kid or below the 14 and 15 years kid, they are having alkaline phosphate level is very high. That is not abnormal. That is required for the growth of that kids. But now in the elder case, it must be a certain level, that is 100 and 150 between. If that level is increases, then there is a problem in a liver working. Now, albumin test. Albumin is the main protein made up by the liver, and albumin test measure how well your liver is smoking this particular protein. In the case of smoking, it increases. A low result on this test indicate that liver is not functioning properly. We can find out the functioning of liver by the albumin test. Now next is bilirubin test. Bilirubin is a waste material ordinarily processed by the liver. A damaged liver can't properly process bilirubin. This leads to abnormally high level of bilirubin in the blood. A high result of bilirubin test indicate the liver is not functioning and patient is suffering from the jaundice. So if patient is suffering from the jaundice, then you can easily understand his liver is not working properly, and process of bilirubin waste is not doing by the liver in proper manner. So this is directly related with liver function. Now, a typical range of AST, that is 0 to 35 unit, ALT 0 to 35 unit, and ALP, that is phosphate, alkaline phosphate, 30 to 12 units. But in kids, I told you, it has become near about 400, and that is not abnormal because they are in growing stage. But after the 14, it becomes a serious matter. Similarly, CGT, that is 0 to 70% unit, and bilirubin, that is 0.1 to 1 mg per deciliter. It directly means the breakdown product of hemoglobin bonds to albumin conjugate in a liver with hemolysis and cholestasis through the liver injury. laboratory test for kidney function. Laboratory test for kidney function, it is a first is urea clearance test. The urea clearance test required blood sample to measure the amount of urea in a blood stream, and the two urine specimen collected 1 hour apart to determine the amount of urea that is filtered cleared by the kidney into the urine. So this is important test for the kidney function test. Now urine osmolality test. Urine osmolality test is measure of a number of dissolved particle in a urine. The test may be done on urine sample collected first thing in the morning. First urine sample is important for the any test of urine. So multiple time sample also we can check, or cumulative sample collected in a 24 hours, that is also carried out. Now next is blood urea nitrogen test, that is called BUN. The blood urea nitrogen test is measure the amount of nitrogen contained in a urea. The high BUN level can indicate kidney is not functioning properly, kidney dysfunction. But because of BUN is also affected by the protein intake and liver function, the test is usually done together with a blood creatinine, a more specific indicator of the kidney function. Now next is creatinine clearance test. With the normal kidney function, the amount of creatinine in the blood remains relatively constant and normal. For this reason, and because of creatinine is affected very little by the liver function, and elevated blood creatinine level is more sensitive indicator of impaired kidney function than the BUN. BUN may be related with the liver, but this creatinine level is increases in your urine. It directly so the your renal function is not proper, or your kidney is not functioning. That is, I told you, it is a silent killer, and you can't understand. There is no symptoms. Your creatinine concentration is increasing in your urine, that is not increasing and not going give any symptoms, and suddenly your kidney become fail. So it is very serious, and when we are going for routine checkup, we must do the creatinine test, that is related with kidney function. Now urine albumin. Healthy kidney have filters nephron. These remove wastage but keep in a large cell like red blood cells, proteins, albumin. Albumin is one type of protein. When the filters, it damage and they make a leak protein into the urine. The albumin levels can go up if you exercise a lot or have a high blood sugar too. So a diabetes patient also having, and persons who they directly doing a heavy exercise, after that there is a chances of albumin passes through the urine. Now bladder infection can also make the level go up. So urinary tract infection also affect the urine level. The other blood test measure on the blood level of the other element regulate in part by the kidney can also be useful in evaluating kidney function test. This includes sodium, potassium, carbon dioxide, बाइकार्बोनेट्स कैल्शियम मैग्नीशियम फास्फोरस प्रोटीन यूरिक यूरिक एसिड एंड ग्लूकोज. सो दीज आर रिलेटेड विद द किडनी फंक्शन टेस्ट. नाउ टिपिकल रेफरेंस रेंज ऑफ in a kidney function test of some ions or component, the sodium level is 35 to 145 millimole per liter. It is usually caused by the excess water. It decreases when usually we are taking the excess water intake. Serum antidiuretic hormones is treated with the water restriction. If we restrict the intake of water, then there is a chances. It is severe dehydration. The concentration of sodium increases, or diabetes insipidus. The significant renal or renal function is not proper, or renal disease condition, that concentration may increase in the blood, or if sodium losses through a GIT, then also there is a chances. Now potassium level 3.5 to 5 millimole per liter. It increases with the renal dysfunction, acidosis. If we are treating with a diuretic like potassium aspartate diuretic, then also it is a chances to concentration is increased. Hemolysis condition, burn condition, injury also cause the same. Now the concentration of potassium is decreases by the directly treating with diuretics, or you are suffering from the alkaloids, or treating alkaloids, consuming alkaloids, or severe vomiting and diarrhea condition, the concentration of potassium may decrease. Now third is the carbon dioxide, 22 to 28 millimole per liter. It is carbon dioxide present in a bicarbonate form, H plus and HCO3 minus, that is a bicarbonate ion. It is a maintain the acid base balance in a body. I told you it is a buffer system, biological buffers, which maintain the pH of the biological fluid. Now calcium concentration, it become 8.5 to 10.5 mg per deciliter. Concentration of calcium increases due to hyperthyroidism, bone tumor, increase the absorption from the bone of extracellular electrolyte or extracellular fluid. That calcium is coming from the bone to extracellular fluid is also increase the level of calcium. It decreases the neuromuscular activity. Similarly, when calcium concentration is decreased, there is a chances of dietary deficiency. You have to take calcium outside from the outside sources through diet or through in the form of tablet or injectables. Similarly, increase the excretion, pancreatic secretion. Hypothyroidism, rickets also is a osteomalacia, is a normal condition in which the calcium level is decreases. In this disease, calcium concentration is decreases. Now, chloride concentration, it is in between 98 to 106 milliequivalent per liter. It affect by the concentration of chloride vary from the normal values due to dehydration, multiple myeloma. kidney disorders, adrenal gland function, etc. Similarly, the phosphorus value is 2.4, that is in between 2.4 to 4.1 mg per deciliter, and it affect kidney and parathyroid gland dysfunction. Now, next is serum creatinine level. It is in women, that is 0.6 to 1.1, and in men, that is 0.7 to 1.3 mg per deciliter. The creatinine clearance in women, that is 88 to 128 ml per minute, and men, that is 97 to 137 ml per minute. Urine albumin, it become a 0 to 8 mg per deciliter. Blood urea nitrogen, that is BUN, 7 to 20 mg per deciliter. Next is microalbumin. Urine microalbumin is 30 mg, less than 30 mg, and 30 mg to 300 mg, mainly the early CKD, that creatinine urine microalbumin, that is because of the kidney dysfunction, its concentration is vary from the normal values. Now, albumin to creatinine ratio, it should be less than 30 mg per gram. So, these are the normal values related to the kidney function test. Now, laboratory test for diabetes. This table shows the ranges of blood glucose level after the 8 to 12 fasting, person not eating, or 8 to 12 hours fasting. It shows the normal range, and the normal ranges are sign of the pre-diabetes or diabetes condition. If is vary from the normal range. The typical reference ranges for the healthy adult is plasma glucose result is if 70 to 99, that is diagnosis normal value, and plasma glucose concentration, that is 100 to 125, that is pre-diabetic, and more than 126, that is a diabetic condition, or glucose level is higher than normal values. So these are the some tests you can refer for the diabetes mellitus. Oral glucose tolerance test, OGTT. A 2 hours 75 gram oral glucose tolerance test is used to test for the diabetes. A healthcare provider will take fasting lab, draw a blood to test your fasting glucose level, and they will then ask to drink 8 ounces of syrupy glucose solution, or you have to take 75 gram sugar in the same laboratory at the same time where they tested fasting sugar. After that, you take the 75 gram sugar and then wait in the same laboratory for the 2 hours. The healthcare provider will draw the blood sample once again after 2 hours, and typical references of the OGTT, that is oral glucose tolerance test for the adults, that is given here. Fasting, it is 100 to 125, and for diabetes more than 126, that is the if it varies from the more than 92, it become a chances of diabetes. After 1 hour, It should not more than 180 after 2 hours. It should not be greater than 153. So this is a test we are performing for the applying for the some insurance or some insurance in the age of more than 40 or more than 50. After that, if you are applying for the insurance, then company will do this test, oral glucose tolerance test, for the checking whether you are suffering from diabetes or not. So they are first they are taking the fasting glucose. After that, they will give you 75 gram oral glucose, and they will measure the concentration of blood glucose level after the 2 hours. Now next is hemoglobin. Hemoglobin A1C test that tells your average level of blood sugar over the past 2 to 3 months. It's also called HbA1c test, glycylated hemoglobin test, also called glycohemoglobin. It is also known as glycohemoglobin test. People who have diabetes need this test regularly basis to see their level of staying within range or not. It can be tell you need to adjust your diabetes medicine as well as your diets, how to take your diet in certain intervals. The A1C test is also used to diagnose the diabetes when glucose build up in your blood. It binds to a hemoglobin in your red blood cells, and the A1 test is measured how much glucose is bound. So this is some reference value is given here. A1C test and blood glucose. Now next is thyroid function test. This group of tests assess the thyroid gland, which regulate metabolism in the body. The whole group will be ordered if there are sign of low or high thyroid hormones output on a physical examination. Sometimes just one test we are doing, that is TSH, will be ordered to rule out the thyroid problems when symptoms might be difficult to explain. The usual blood test done for the thyroid function are TSH, that is T4 test. Sometimes we are doing T3 test. Usually the free and active portion of T4 and T3 is measured in the test FT4, FT3. The laboratory use reference ranges to compare blood test result with the result in the normal healthy population. The typical reference ranges of healthy adult of TSH, FT4, FT3, that is ranges in between 0.4 to 4, 9.0 to 25.0, and 3.5 to 7.5. This is a thyroid function test, whether your thyroid gland is working properly or not. It directly regulates your metabolism as well as your growth of body. So this thyroid function test is important for the patient who is suffering from the disease and normal not getting the normal growth at that condition. A doctor or physician may ask to do this test in your blood. Vitamin D and vitamin B12 test, that is very a common and expensive test, but nowadays physicians are prescribing this test for the checking the whether that deficiency is present or not in the patient. So vitamin D test, that is normal value, normal range 30 to 74 nanogram in per milliliter, 25 hydroxy vitamin D when calcium is low and the person has symptoms of vitamin D deficiency such as bone malfunctions in the children, that is rickets, and bone weakness, softness, fractures in an adult, that is osteomalacia. The 25 hydroxy vitamin D usually is disordered to identify a possible deficiency of vitamin D, that is 1 and 25 dihydroxy vitamin D. This test thing may be ordered when the kidney disease and abnormalities of enzyme that convert 25 hydroxy vitamin D. Basically, vitamin D is a structure of steroidal skeleton, and a steroidal skeleton at 25 position hydroxyl group must be present, but that 25 hydroxyl group vitamin D converted into a 125 dihydroxy vitamin D, that is due to the kidney disease or kidney abnormalities. So we can also find out through this test the function of kidney, where it is working proper or not. Rarely this test may be done when calcium is high or a person has a disease that might produce excess amount of vitamin D, such as sarcoidosis and some form of lymphoma. There is a chances of this formation of 125 dihydroxy vitamin D, and by we can check the disease condition of the patient, which are the cause which convert the 25 dihydroxy vitamin D to 125 dihydroxy vitamin D. It is also happened due to the immune cell or immune system is not working properly, or kidney is not functioning properly. This vitamin D test, if you are having the deficiency of vitamin D, then a doctor is prescribing to take sun bath in the morning time. That is a very common source of vitamin, or very important source of vitamin D, that is a morning sunlight. Now vitamin B12, this the normal values of vitamin B12 in infants up to 6 month age, it is 0.4 microgram. In babies, it is 0.5 microgram. In children's 1 to 3, it is 0.9 microgram. Kids 4 to 8 years, that is 1 to 1.2 microgram.